him.
Thank you.
Rounds. But the kid, someone told me the kid couldn't punch, and they lied to me. And his overhand right kept popping me right on the eye. And after a while, he knew it. Just the only thing that saved me was the residue of my power.
Residue?
Yeah.
Did you feel rusty? I mean,
oh man, a couple of times I got easy knockouts, but you're in the ring, the crowd is interfering with your business, and it throws you off. But the most important thing is the punch was still there. And for the first time in my life, I had to be on the receiving end. So rust will get you in trouble.
What did you feel about your jab tonight, George?
The jab was the most powerful thing. If I didn't have a left jab, I probably would have been in big trouble. Every time I landed a jab, it would knock him too far away to land a right hand up.
George!
Would you have gone 10?
I was intending to go at least 8 or 9 rounds, but I told Jack Fitz earlier I wanted to just break the rust, but I didn't like the swelling coming in my eyes, and I just had to go for a knockout then.
Swelling or the sweat, you say? I'm sorry.
The swelling. I started refilling a swelling over my left eye, and I just couldn't take any chances.
George, you didn't put him down, George.
Huh?
You didn't put him down.
Well, thank goodness. I mean, he started taking it.
Would that have been better?
For who?
Well,
George, it looked like you were talking to the referee.
You said to stop.
Well, I had him, and he couldn't even see me, you know, just bagging away. I asked him, I said, well, what do you want me to do? And then he said, well, I said, he's hurt. He said, well, good, do your job. And then he started catching, and his eyes went, I guess, on the other side of his mind, and the referee saw it and just stopped it.
I know the jab set him up, but it seemed like the left hook really hurt him.
The left hook was just powerful. My power is the most, that saved me.
In the second round, you threw a left, and you turned to the referee quickly, as if you had hurt him.
And what
round
was
that? Round? No, at the end, just before the end. No, you did that.
You know what? I've been sparring so long that I've hurt guys in sparring that it's automatically I stop and give them a break. That's the truth. It backfired on me. I hit him with a good left hook and said, let me give him time to recover.
How'd it feel to be back in the ring? Do you enjoy this? Is that why you're here? I didn't see too many whys here. You're back in the ring.
Well, I'm back in it. Basically, most fighters, most athletes, they either seek to be reinstated after years of retirement or whatever into amateur status to receive medals. But when you go for professional, that word means for money.
How about the choice of opponents? Are you glad you held out for him?
Huh?
Are you glad you held out for him over the other guys?
Right. The other guys are, let me tell you, who wants a hard fight, but who want to get out there and see a guy get hit and start trying to quit? This guy got hit. I mean, he just couldn't see anything for a second, but he didn't say, I'm going to lay down.
George, what do you think you proved tonight? What do you think you proved tonight?
Well, I didn't prove anything. I wasn't really trying to find you guys. I was actually trying to get out of the way of you. I wanted to get back in the ring about 250 or 65 pounds and fight my way back into conditioning. I remember Sacramento 12, 15 years ago. It was just a little town. But I come back here, and man, they got sports writers looking like what's that fellow on CBS? Dan Rather. Well, that, hey, you're 38 years old, 39, 40, whatever they want to give you. It doesn't mean that I'm dead or you dead. You don't listen to critics. So what? I had a little extra weight on. So what? I'm still a man. I'm still alive, and I could still, if Russia would try to attack us, the 40-year-old guys would push them right back over the border.
Do you think you can do shit?
Well, I got the punch, no doubt. But I still admire those young fellas out there. I'm not going to knock them like you guys have been. I admire them. Mike Tyson.
I had never intended on doing that. I wasn't about to turn it into a Ron Lyle fight, you know, just swinging wild.
But, you know, you're naming all the guys that he fought so many years ago. That sort of shows that you knew that you're fighting George Foreman.
Oh, sure. But the intimidation wasn't because of his name. It was just because that's the way I thought I could beat him, just moving side to side. And punching off of those moves, you know, letting him swing and miss me, and then me counterpunch, and I just didn't have my timing. Maybe it's about time I started thinking about the end of a career, because last couple of fights, I haven't had a lot of sparring, but maybe, I'm sure that would help too. But I had some this time, and I should have had better timing and thrown more punches. Couldn't throw him. His size had a lot to do with it, and his strength. You know, I even when I got inside a couple times, I was going to throw some. It didn't take much for those big arms to hold my arms down, or if I threw him over the top and just a little bit, he'd move that, and it was like running into a brick wall. You know, it was just right there. So he's still got, you know, a little bit of. He's got some moves.
One time he just took his jab almost. Extended it and shoved it into the ring.
Yeah.
How long ago were you with the Petronellis?
About 3.5 years.
3.5 years ago? Or?
Yeah.
How long were you with them?
Just about 4 years ago.
Okay.
Thank you.
How long were you with them?
5 years.
Just a minute ago, he said that he had a lot of respect for the young guys. You're one of the young guys. How does that make you feel?
I don't feel like one of the young guys. It's I'm getting very close to the end of my career, and
you
know,
no.
He's, you know, I'm glad to hear he's got some respect for me. I've got plenty for him, certainly. He's. It takes a lot to come back. Hell, I'm 32, and it's hard to train. He's 38. Of course, I wish that's all I had to do was train, and not. You know, I mean, I wish I didn't have to worry about working too, and be able to train a lot harder. But, you know, I have a lot of respect for the guy. He's still got some skills, and he's got the size and the power. You know, he can beat some fighters.
What did you do
at
the, you worked in a traffic department?
For 10 years out of the ring, excess weight, 55 pounds heavier. The guy didn't look too bad. Let's be honest.